This is a composition of David Tronzo's new composition entitled Unnamed.
Thank you. Thank you.
Christian Kögel, David Tronzo, Jerry Granelli, Unnamed. Thank you.
What were we seeking? We were seeking some form of freedom in the music. Because I remember when we got together out in Minneapolis.
For the first V16 record.
Yeah.
And with Anthony Cox was playing. Cox was playing bass.
Yeah, and Christian was with us. And we threw together all this very strangely different music, which can either be a plus or a tremendous minus. But if you're really, I think if we, the way we went about it, you know, if one is going to be an improvising musician in the tradition of the great jazz interpreters,
yeah,
right?
Yes.
They take any piece of music and they just make it their own.
Yeah.
And that's what we did. Thank you.
We'll be right back. There's going to be you. David Tronzo on guitar, ladies and gentlemen. Christian Kögel on guitar. That was Christian's composition. J. Anthony Granelli, no relation, on bass.
We went out to Vancouver, flew out to Vancouver to do the third V16 record. We did one, in, I don't know, 5 years ago or something now, the first record. And then J. Anthony joined the band, replacing Anthony Cox. Then 2 years ago, we did the Sonic Temple record. And each time the band has progressed, the music has changed from playing pretty much all free music to beginning to form the band compositionally so that the compositions reflect the way this band improvises. And now with this new music, the third record, which is always interesting for a group of musicians to make three records, you know. A, people know what you sounded like before, and it's hard to do now in these times. And this record is really all music that's specifically written to reflect where we are. We've spent a lot of time together. We spent 2 weeks every year in Halifax. We've done tours in Europe now, played in the United States. So it's a real band. And the sound of the band has grown and changed.
When I hear it back, I'm excited by what I hear on the takes. Nothing thrills me more than hearing something on a CD that I don't know how I did that. With V16, I'm hearing constantly, even more so on this CD, the new one, Vancouver 08, you know. We came together in Halifax. We rehearsed for 2 days, just clarifying the material. You have to know it. You have to get completely inside the composition, and then you can go from there. We did a concert here at Halifax. Then we went to Vancouver, and then went to Seattle, and then came back and recorded. Anytime you spend a lot of time with four guys, you know, it's beautiful, and it's raw, it's real, it's human relationships. It's not a studio recording in that sense. Basically, there's two takes, maybe. It's as close to playing in a live with a live audience as possible, because that's what is the most comfortable. Perhaps you keep growing, I hope. And this band certainly is a constant growth process, I hope.
This one is a new composition of Christian Kögel, and it's called Wellfare.
Thank you.
Christian Kögel, Jerry Granelli. Yeah, that was really pretty. That was two compositions, actually. It was Wellfare that went into that lovely thing at the end, which was called Udon, Waltz.
Two guitars, yeah. I guess I started on that voyage in 1976 in Colorado. In the first band I had with two guitars, pedal guitar and electric guitar. I don't know. It's just a sound in my head that I loved, I guess, you know. And I proceeded with this journey of trying to, you know, working with different combinations of that, great, great things. And V16 is a remarkable for me, not fruition, but a high point of that journey. The relationship between Christian and Tronzo is really fantastic. There's this tremendous appreciation, you know, like they knock each other out. And at the same time, they have the quality of being able to sound like one huge guitar. So that's part of the inspiration of the band, is to create an orchestral sound. So you can't tell who's who sometimes, and what's, you know, it takes, sometimes you hear the sound and you have to realize it takes both guitars to actually make this sound you like. Plus, now the way the bass is used, which is all reflected in the writing too, that becomes the third stringed instrument. So it's this large string sound that's improvised orchestral music.
Mm-hmm.
It's interesting because they're all a band of leaders. They all have their own projects, but they all come together and are willing to give that up in some way. It's an interesting thing because you can't give it up completely. We always talk about serving the music, and that's what playing with them is like. There's a lot of service to the music that's going on. And that what allows the things to change, you know, from somebody taking a solo and then it being somebody else's solo. So there's this constant influx of organic playing going on, which could only happen in people who have spent time playing together. It's built in. And the other built-in thing about this group of players, the chemistry, is like whatever we touch turns to us or turns to this weird thing, you know, we touch a tune and that's what something comes out of it, you know. So doing this record was part of it was to go on tour, play live, and what you're seeing here is part of the concert in Vancouver, the first concert, second concert on the tour. Live playing, you can do a lot of things because you're exchanging energy with the audience. There's something going on in that whole moment. The music draws everybody together in a spontaneous interaction, and people become part of it. You know, but you're not trying to seduce them into it. Mm-hmm.
Oh, this is Christian Kögel's composition.
Bossa, where art thou?